Jenny Reynolds, Brett Boyer, David Hamburger, and I'm Matt Smith. What we're going to talk about today with this particular video is how to keep and motivate your students. I've always felt goal-oriented teaching is the most important way to keep a student engaged. In other words, so if I say, all right, what do you want to do with all this? Do you want to play in a band? Do you want to write songs? Do you want to just play guitar for fun? And then it gives me a sense of where to take them.
Basically, what you're doing is showing them that everything that you teach them applies towards the goals that they've stated. If you're having trouble keeping students, usually it's because you're anticipating that the student you have is like you and wants to learn tons of stuff. And usually that's not the case. Usually what they want is a comfortable amount of things and to feel like everything that they're learning is going towards their goal.
Part of it is figuring out what kind of student is this. Like a lot of adults that I encounter now, they don't want to come every week for a half an hour. They want to get a bunch of information and go work on it, partly because sometimes they're self-conscious. They don't want to be, like you were saying about professionals that are good at something else, they don't want to be bad in front of you every week.
One of the biggest things for me has been writing, composition. As far as motivating students, they get a much deeper understanding of all the elements contained within rather than playing someone else's song. And the way I always explain to them, if you wrote it, it's right.
For me, I break down into big categories. There's the how, the what, and the why. And the why is the deepest for me. This is how I think of it when I teach. I mean, since we're talking about keeping students and motivating students, they want to stay with you more because the how you can get on the internet. And anytime you experience anything at a deep level, you can start to pull other things down there as well. And so if you've written this song that you really care about, you play it differently than you might some song that you've wanted to play forever.
What I try to do here, and I need to find time to do more of, is to pull my students in to have informal playing sessions with each other so they get to play with other human beings. For someone who's starting out, they're first starting out teaching. They have no idea what to do. What advice would you give them?
I would suggest you do this. I would divide the lesson into fundamentals, into some different things that they're aiming towards their goals. And then the last part are songs in whatever way they can play it. If they can play the first four bars, we loop the first four bars. You know how it is when you play with a good musician. They're lifting you up. It's almost a physical thing. I try to provide that every week for every student.
I like having them record themselves. I like in practice time and name the file with a date in it or just make sure there's a date in it and put the title of the song and then wait a week and do it again and go back and listen to both. They don't realize they're getting better.
I record every single lesson I teach and I always tell my students, bring a notebook and bring a list of questions and bring a USB stick. So I just record every lesson, and at the end of every lesson, I bounce it to an MP3, and I give them the MP3, and I said, now you can study your lesson, just so that they can listen back to everything that was said, and also listen to their questions being answered.
I'm really just trying to convey the sense that, like, this is all possible if you just are patient, you know, and my job is just to make it as clear as possible to you so there's no obstacles to your understanding it. Because I was not like a whiz kid, you know. I'm like, if I could figure out how to do this, you can too.
I just teach the way that I would want to be taught. I would want a goal every lesson. In other words, I'd want something to do. Thoroughly explaining the concept and then applying the concept to something and then some kind of homework for the next lesson.
If I'm always learning something, then I'm always motivated. And if I'm always motivated, then my students are always motivated. And that is contagious too.
The reason they're there is to share your space, your time, your energy. It's the uniqueness of teaching private lessons.
And good luck in your teaching endeavors. Thanks so much from Six String Ranch in Austin, Texas.